Hello students, I am Professor Khushbu Kayas from Sri Sitaram Bhai Narayan Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Mundra, Badami. Today in this lecture, we are going to discuss what is communication, objectives of communication and the process of communication. From the subject, Effective Technical Communication, and its subject code is 313004. Now, let's discuss what is communication. As we all know that communication is truly a multisensory experience, so we can say that communication is a series of experience. It involves hearing, smell, seeing, taste and touch. Now let's discuss from where the word communication derived. It is a Latin word, communis, which means common, and thus the word communication states the commonness between the transmitter and the receiver with reference to the message that need to be transmitted. So this is a simple phenomenon of communication, that it is a Latin word. That means what? A commonness between a transmitter and the receiver and the message that they wanted to transfer. Now let us define how we can say what is communication. Communication means an exchange of facts, ideas, informations, opinion and emotions between two or more persons. So in simple language, communication is a common phenomenon. As we all are social animal, we cannot live without communicating. Communication implies a two-way communication process of transferring informations, ideas, feelings or opinions through a channel between two or more persons, either verbally, that is through speech or writing, or non-verbally through signals, behavior, gesture, posture, etc. Now we are going to discuss objectives of communication. Number one is to provide orientation or induction to the new person. When person is newly hired by your organization or company, it is very important to give them proper orientation or induction program for making them familiar with your company or organization. Number two, to assign work and give instruction to the subordinates about whatever the assignment that you wanted to accomplish. Number three, to developing understanding and creative solution through active and inactive participants of member. You can also find a creative solution of a problem by effective participating in communication. Number next is to keep superior informed about the progress and problems that you are facing in operation of any of the machinery or any of the required goal. Number next, to exercise control on the use of human and non-human resources or inputs. Next objective is to enhance ability to work through training and development. Training and development is indeed a very important thing for a newly hired or the person who wanted to update it themselves. So through effective communication, you can also enhance your worker's ability or employee's ability to performance well. Next is to encourage people to contribute their best in form of suggestions and recommendations. You can also encourage your people to give their valuable suggestions and recommendations if they wanted to give. Next objective is to allow, it also allows the people to ventilate their feelings. Like you can, through effective communication, you can also involve your people for giving their suggestion in form of written or oral. Next objective is to to enhance the effectiveness of decision by providing relevant information and engagement of discussion. Like you should also have to provide sufficient information to your people so that it also encourage them to participate in discussion for making a effective decision. Next objective is to develop the goodwill and brand image of the organization through publicity before the outsider. Now, another objective is to enhance work efficiency through latest technology, adoption of state of art, and by redefining priorities continuously. So, you have to define your priority first. Those tasks need to be completed first, give them a higher priority, and another one can be given a lower priority. So these are the objectives that we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss communication process. So communication is a bridge of understanding between the transmitter, that is communicator, and the receiver, that is communicating, through some medium or channel. So simply, a communication process refers to a series of actions or steps taken in order to successfully communicate. It involves several components such as sender, encode, medium or channel, decode, receiver, and feedback. Now let's discuss it in detail how communication process works. So it is a whole communication cycle, starting from transmitter, then it comes encoding, that it comes medium and channel, then decoding and the receiver and feedback. So without feedback, your communication cycle is not completed. So now let us discuss it step by step. Number one is transmitter, or you can say sender or source. So the need of communication only arises when someone has a intention to convey something to other party. Other party over here in the sense of receiver. So transmitter is a communicator, or you can say sender is a communicator, receiver is a communicator, and the detail to be transmitted is the message. So form of message can be any alphabetic languages, arithmetic digits, symbols, figures, etc. It can be anything. Then it's come encoding. So the sender, or we can say transmitter, puts the ideas and thoughts into some logical or coded message. So they can use alphabets, digits, symbols, figures, graph, etc. It can be used by them. Now it's time to use some medium or channel through that you wanted to pass your message. So channel of communication can be a three type. It can be written, it can be verbal, or it can be non-verbal. So let us see written communication. You can use print media, letter, emails, booklets, circular, telegram in written form of communication. Where we are talking about verbal one, you can use lecture, telephonic conversation, digital communications are part of verbal communication. Now number three is non-verbal. You can use body language, sign and gesture, your posture, that are non-verbal communication without words. So these are the medium or channel that you can use. Now another one is decoding. So the receiver converts the message into thoughts. Now it's time to decode the message from the receiver. So receiver over here is translating the message which is received from a sender. The message is decoded by changing the symbol into a meaning. So over here, receiver is trying to understand the message which is sent by sender. Now, number five is receiver. So receiver over here we can call as a target audience, the one to whom we are sending a message. So it may be an individual, it may be a group of person. The process of communication only completes where the receiver receives the message and understand it and trying to give what? Respond to it. So your communication cycle only completes when you got a feedback from your receiver. Let us understand what is feedback. So the transmission of receiver's response to the sender is called as feedback. So feedback is very important, or I can say very essential parameter for any effective communication. So your communication cycle cannot complete until you get response from your recipients, that is from a receiver. Otherwise, what you have to do? You have to resend the message to your ultimate sender. So this is how your communication process can end. I hope you understand it. Thank you all for listening to me. Thank you very much.